Hi guys, so we are back with another lecture in the Fast Track series for RBI Grade B, which has been brought to you by EduTap. Before proceeding forward, let us briefly look at what this series entails for you guys. So in this particular series, we are going to attain a comprehensive coverage of current affairs from the month of May 2018 to 15th August 2018, that is before your examination. And again, in this particular series, we are going to alternatively cover topics of ESI, that is economic and social issues, and finance and management, which will be covered through important problems under multiple choice questions or MCQs. Now, we have been working in this direction for the past few years, and we have been blessed with some of the very amazing results in the past few years. Now, in RPA Grade B 2017 results, 124 of our students, they reached the interview stage, and 27 of the students, they made it to the final list. Now, apart from the different other courses which we are running, we are offering these courses for RBI Grade B 2018 examination. So these are the different courses which you guys can choose from. So there is a wide range of courses and you can choose according to your requirement. Also, we are running presently discounts on the EduTap courses. So the subscribers of 2017 courses, they can get a flat 30% discount. And for this, they have to drop a mail at deepak@edutap.co.in. And the new subscribers, they can get a flat 20% discount using the coupon code of 20. Now, in case you need to know more, you have any query, you can always visit our website, which is www.edutap.co.in, or you can drop us a mail at deepak@edutap.co.in, or you can call us at 8146-207-241. In this particular video, we are going to focus on some of the very important reports, the reports which have been released recently and which are very important for our upcoming examination. So let's start with the first question. Which of the following is incorrect regarding Global Economic Prospects Report? Now the options are, it is published by International Monetary Fund, it examines global economic developments and prospects with special focus on developing and emerging market economies, it is issued twice a year in January and June. All are correct, none of the above is correct. So this question is based on the Global Economic Prospects Report. So if we are aware about this particular report, which organization is concerned with this report, and some of the very basic features of this report, we can easily handle this question. So let us look at some of the key aspects of Global Economic Prospects Report. Now, the most important aspect of this report is that it is a flagship report of World Bank Group. So this is the World Bank's report and not IMF's report. Now, this report examines global economic developments with special focus on developing and emerging market economies. So this is very general. Now, important fact is that it is issued twice a year in January and June. So this is very important that this report is released twice a year. So this is very important. We may forget that this is released in January and June, but we have to remember that this is issued twice a year. And the first edition, the January edition, it includes in-depth analysis of some topical policy challenges, while the June edition, it contains shorter analytical pieces. Now, the 2018 Global Economic Prospects Report, which was released recently by the World Bank, it has projected India's growth rate to increase to 7.3% in 2018 and 7.5% for the next 2 years, that is 2019 and 2020. So this is very important. A question may be directly asked, what is the projected growth rate of India as per the World Bank's Global Economic Prospects Report? So we have to remember these figures. Also, according to the report, despite some initial setbacks which India faced owing to demonetization and GST, still India managed to grow at 6.7% in 2017, and this 6.7% is higher than what was estimated by the government, that is 6.5%. Now, the report also points out that India has enormous growth potential compared to other emerging economies if we go forward and focus on implementing some of the key comprehensive reforms similar to demonetization and GST. So now we can easily answer this question. Which of the following is incorrect regarding Global Economic Prospects Report? So clearly the first option is incorrect because this is a flagship report of World Bank. So answer would be option number A. So now let us move on to the next question. According to the recently released United Nations Sustainable Development Goals 2018 report, so this is a very recent report and can be asked in the examination, which of the following are the key factors for rising hunger in the world? So this report has said that the hunger in the world is rising, and we simply need not remember that, okay, hunger is rising, but we have to remember why hunger is rising. And we are given some points here. First is conflict, two, drought, third is disasters linked to climate change. And the options are 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 1 and 3, 1, 2 and 3, and none of the above. So for answering this particular question, we must have some basic understanding about this particular report, and we must have gone through this report. We must have taken an overview of this report, and that this report talks about rising hunger, and it mentions some of the key factors for this particular aspect. So let us briefly learn about this particular report. Now this report, it is simply an overview of progress towards achieving 2030 agenda for sustainable development goals. Now these are the sustainable development goals we have to achieve by 2030, and these have been set by the United Nations, and they comprise of 17 goals and 169 targets to be achieved by 2030. So the deadline is 2030, and they were adopted by the UN Sustainable Development Summit on September 25, 2015. So this report, it talks about an overview of these sustainable development goals. So these are the 17 sustainable development goals, and the important ones include the sustainable development one, goal 1, which is no poverty, 2, which is zero hunger, 3, which is related to health, 4, which is related to education, 5, which is related to gender equality, 6, which is related to clean water and sanitation, 13th, which is related to climate action, and 17th, which is related to promoting partnerships for the goals. Now let us briefly look at the key highlights of this particular report, which was released recently. Now this report has said that the number of hungry people in the world have risen for the first time in more than a decade. So this is a very important finding of this particular report, that the number of hungry people in the world are rising. And for this particular purpose, it has listed 3 key factors, and they are conflict, drought, and disasters linked to climate change. So these are the factors which are driving food insecurity in the world. Now the report says that there are now approximately 38 million more undernourished people in the world. So they were earlier 777 million. Now they have risen to around 815 million. So this is challenging. We have to do something on this front, that the number of undernourished or hungry people are rising. So we have to work on this particular area. Now it also says that the number of people which are living on less than $2 a day, so this is the limit which has been set by and acknowledged by many international organizations, including World Bank. So the number of people which are living on less than $2 a day, this population has declined from 26.9% to 9.2% in 2017. So this is an achievement. Now the mortality rate for children under 5 has also dropped by almost 50% for least developed countries. So this is also an achievement. So if we analyze this report, the key concern is that the number of hungry people in the world is rising, and the achievements are made on the front that the number of people living on less than $2 a day, they have fallen, and the mortality rate for children under 5, it has also dropped. Now let us also briefly look at the findings which this report has made with respect to South Asia. So the report says that says that this region has seen child marriage rates decline. So this is a key achievement for this region. And the water stress level for many countries in the region are above 70%, and this is a key concern that we are fast approaching water scarcity. And also it says that more than 9 out of 10 people which are living in urban areas around the world are breathing polluted air, and the southern Asian cities are scoring worst on this particular front. So this pollution is a key challenge for the world as well as the South Asian countries. And also it says that the while electricity and sanitation deficits in the South Asian region are still poor, but the efforts are being increasingly made by the governments of the countries to bridge this particular gap. So now we can easily answer this question, that the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals 2018 reports, it points to the rising hunger in the world, and all these factors, conflict, drought, and disasters linked to climate change, are responsible for this. So answer would be option number D. Now let us move on to the next question. According to the recently released FR Asia Bank Global Wealth Migration Review, India is the dash wealthiest country in the world. So this is an important report which was released recently, and it talks about the global wealth, and it has placed India on in top 10 countries in terms of wealth, and we are being asked about the position which has been accorded to India. So first of all, we should be aware about this particular report, which is the Global Wealth Migration Review, and which this is done by the Afro-Asian Bank. And as per this report, India is the sixth wealthiest country in the world, and the total wealth of India is estimated at $8,230 billion. So this is an important figure, and this is also important that India is the sixth wealthiest country in the world. Now, this Afro-Asian Bank, this is a bank which is headquartered in the Mauritius International Financial Center, and this is the bank which has released this particular report. It specializes in banking that builds the bridges between Asia, Africa and the world. So this is specifically focusing on the Asian as well as the African region so that they grow and keep in touch with the entire world. Now, as per this report, it has given a definition of the wealth, and the wealth refers to the private wealth which is held by all the individuals, and this includes all their assets minus all the liabilities which they are having, and we are excluding government funds from the definition of wealth in this particular report. This is not much important. We have to remember that India is the sixth wealthiest country as per this report. Now, the top 10 countries, they include on the top is the US, and then is the China, then Japan, UK, Germany, and then comes India. So the first country, the country which topped the list, is US, and China is also ahead of India in this particular wealthiest countries report. Now, on the global front, this report says that the total private wealth which is being held worldwide, it is around $215 trillion. So this is the total private wealth which is being held worldwide. The figure is $215 trillion, and the report says there are around 15.2 million high net worth individuals in the world. Further, the report says that some of the factors which are going to help India achieve a 200% rise in the wealth growth forecast, they include good educational system, large entrepreneurs, robust outlook for IT, etc. The report says that over the next 10 years, India is going to overtake Germany and UK, and India is going to become fourth largest wealth market worldwide by 2027. And with regard to China, the report says that China is also going to witness significant rise in the total wealth in the coming decade. So now we can easily answer this question that India is the sixth wealthiest country in the world as per the Afro-Asia Bank Global Wealth Migration Review. So the answer would be option number C, that is sixth. Now let us move on to the next question. Which of the following is correct regarding the recently released financial stability report of the Reserve Bank of India? Now this is very important for our examination, because this one has been released by RBI, and RBI is going to conduct our examination. So it will be expecting that we are aware about this particular recent report. So we have to tell which are the correct ones. Global growth outlook for 2018 remains positive despite some recent softness. The stress in the banking sector has subsided as gross NPA ratio witnessed decline. Credit growth of scheduled commercial banks has picked up during 2017-18, notwithstanding sluggish deposit growth. And the options are 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 1 and 3, 1, 2 and 3, and none of the above. So first, we should be aware about this financial stability report, and then we should be aware about this some of the important findings which have been made in this recent report. So RBI has recently released June 2018 financial stability report. And the highlights of this particular report, on the global and domestic macroeconomic financial risks front, this report has said that the global growth outlook remains positive. So this is important, that it is optimistic about the global growth outlook. And it also says that the spillover risk from advanced financial markets to emerging markets has increased. So the risk from financial markets in the advanced countries, it is gradually being transferred to the emerging market economy. So this is a challenge. It also says that tightening of liquidity conditions in the developed market alongside the expansionary fiscal policy which is being followed by US, this is going to adversely impact the emerging market currencies, because a large amount of currency inflows come into the emerging markets from the developed markets. So if the liquidity conditions tighten in the developed markets, this is going to substantially impact the developing countries. Now on the domestic front, it says economic growth is picking up, it is firming up. However, it also says that the structural shifts are occurring in the economy and they may alter the pattern of credit intermediation and they may also impact the market interest rates. So we have to remember that this is optimistic about the global growth outlook as well as the economic growth in the country. However, it points to the risks which can be transferred from the advanced financial markets to the emerging markets. Now, with regard to financial institutions, their performance and risks, the report says that the stress in the banking sector continues. So this is important. It has said that the stress in the banking sector is continuing as the gross NPA ratio is rising further. It also says that the profitability of the scheduled commercial banks has declined. As well as it says, the credit growth of scheduled commercial banks, it has picked up during 2017-18. So this is important that credit growth is picking up, though their profitability is declining. And then it also says that the CRAR ratio, it says that the system level CRAR ratio may come down from 13.5% to 12.8%. So this is another important finding. And it also says that the capital augmentation plans which are announced by the government with regard to the financial institutions, they will go a long way in addressing the different issues which are impacting the banks. So on the financial institutions front, we have to remember that the stress in the banking sector continues and the profitability of the banks is declining, though the credit growth has picked up. So now we are in a position to answer this particular question. So now we can easily answer that the first option, that is global growth outlook, remains positive. This is true. And the third one, which says that the credit growth of scheduled commercial banks has picked up, it is also true. However, the second one, which says the stress in the banking sector has subsided, it is false, because the report has said that the stress in the banking sector is continuing and the gross NPA ratio is increasing. So answer would be option number C, 1 and 3. So now let us move on to the next question. According to the recently published Internet Security Threat Report, India has emerged as the dash most vulnerable country in terms of risk of cyber threats. Options are 3rd, 5th, 8th, 10th or none of the above. So to answer this particular question, we must be aware about this particular report which was released recently. So this Internet Security Report, it was recently published and it says that India is the third most vulnerable country in terms of cyber threats such as malware, spam and ransomware in 2017. So this is important that as per the recently published Internet Security Threat Report, which is published by security solution provider Symantec, India has become the third most vulnerable country in terms of cyber threats. And the most vulnerable country is United States, followed by China. And in some other aspects, it states that India is second in terms of countries impacted by spam and bot attacks, third in terms of network attacks, and fourth in terms of ransomware. And overall, which is the most important fact about this particular report, India's position is number third. So now we can easily answer that India has emerged as the third most vulnerable country in terms of risk of credit threats. So answer would be option number A, third. Now the next question, which of the following organization recently released the State of World's Children report? Options are World Bank, UNESCO, UNICEF, World Economic Forum or none of the above. So now we should be aware about this particular report, World's Children report, which has been issued recently. Now the most important aspect of this World's Children report is that it is released by UNICEF. Now the recent edition of this report which was released, it was based on the theme Children in a Digital World. And in this particular respect, it says that globally 12% more men than women, they are using internet in 2017. And it says that if in India, the number of girls and women which are digitally illiterate, they are at the risk of being further marginalized in the society and at home. And it also says that in India, less than 1/3 internet users are female. Only 29% of all internet users are female in India. So this is an important finding of this particular report, that less than 1/3 internet users in India are females. So now we can easily answer this question that the world's children report was recently released by UNICEF. So answer would be option number C. Now moving on to the next question. World Happiness Report 2018 is a publication of which of the following international organizations? And for this one, options are United Nations Sustainable Development Solutions Network, World Bank, World Economic Forum, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, or none of the above. So this question is about World Happiness Report 2018. So to answer this particular report, we should have basic understanding about this particular report. Now this World Happiness Report, it is a measure of happiness around the world. So this is the report which is going to measure happiness which is prevailing around the world, and this particular report is published by an organ of United Nations, which is United Nations Sustainable Development Solutions Network. And as per this report, the top 10 countries in 2018 in terms of happiness, they are, the list is topped by Finland, and then comes Norway, Denmark, etc. And the report also focuses on emerging health problems also. So it focuses on that a good health is essential for being healthy, and we have to get rid of these health problems in order to remain healthy and promote happy economies. So this is the bird's eye view of this particular report. And as per this report, you can see that the world's happiest nation, the list is topped by Finland. And India stands on number 133. So India is very low. It is 133rd country in terms of World Happiness Report. So Indians, they are not happy. So it's something we should work upon. And at the end is Burundi's. This is at the bottom of the table, the most of the countries are African ones. So now we can easily answer that the World Happiness Report 2018 has been published by United Nations Sustainable Development Solutions Network. So the answer is going to be option number A. So now let us move on to the next question. As per the World Economic and Situation Prospects Report 2018. So this is a report which is talking about world economy, and if we are preparing for RPI examination, which is very much linked to the economy, we must be aware about this particular report. Now, as per this report, the global growth is expected to remain steady at -% in 2018 and 19. Now, the options for this one are 1.5%, 3%, 4.5%, 6%, and none of the above. So answering this particular question requires the understanding of this World Economic and Situations Prospect Report. Now this is a report which is released by United Nations. And as per the recent report, the 2018 reports, the key highlights are that in 2017 the world economic growth reached 3%, and this is expected to remain steady in 2018 and 19. It says that in 2017, East and South Asia accounted for nearly half of the global growth. So most of the global growth is there in the East and South Asia. And Indian economy is likely to grow by 7.2% in 2018 and 7.4% in 2019. So these are the key highlights or the key findings of the World Economic and Situation Prospect Report, which is released by UN. So now we can easily answer this question that this World Economic and Situations Prospect Report has said that the global growth is expected to remain steady at 3% in 2018 and 19. So the answer to this one is going to be option number B. Now let us move on to a very important question based on a very important report in global economic scenario, which is the World Bank Ease of Doing Business Report 2018. Now you guys must have read about this particular report almost each and every source of current affairs which you guys must be referring. But considering the importance of this particular report, we have still put a question on this one. Now as per the World Bank Ease of Doing Business Report 2018, in which of the following indicators of doing business did India show improvement? So here we are not asking the rank of India, which you guys must have already crammed by now. We are asking about the indicators in which India has shown improvement. Options are resolving insolvency, paying taxes, getting credit, protecting minority interests, or all of the above. So the World Bank Ease of Doing Business Ranking 2018, and this report assessed 190 economies across the world, and it covered around 10 indicators which cover the life cycle of a business. And as per this report, as we already know, we have read many times that India's ranking has jumped over 30 ranks to attain 100th spot in 2018. Earlier it was 130th in 2017. India's score has also increased from 56 to around 60, and India has seen improvement in 6 out of 10 indicators. So India has seen improvement in most of the indicators, and these indicators are resolving insolvency, paying taxes, getting credit, enforcing contracts, protecting minority investors, and construction permits. So these are the indicators in which India has shown improvement. Further, the report says India is the only country in South Asia and BRICS economies to feature among most improved economies of doing business report this year. So now we can answer this question that on all of these indicators, India has shown improvement in the ease of doing business report 2018. So answer to this one is going to be option number E, all of the above. So now let us move on to the last question of this particular video, which is, according to the United Nations World Water Development Report 2018. So this is based on the most essential commodity of life, which is water. So United Nations World Water Development Report was released recently, and we are being asked about the global demand for water has been increasing at a rate of about 10% per year over the past decades. Options are 0.1%, 1%, 10%, 25%, or none of the above. So now to answer this particular question, we must be aware about the UN World Water Development Report. Now this is a report which was released recently ahead of World Water Day, and this is celebrated on 22nd of March every year. Now this is an annual report which focuses on different strategic water related issues, and the development of the World Water Development Report, it is coordinated by the World Water Assessment Program. The 2018 report is titled Nature-Based Solutions for Water. So this is the theme of the report, Nature-Based Solutions for Water. Now the key highlights of the report, they include the global demand for water, it has increased sixfold over the past 100 years, and the global demand is continuing to grow at the rate of 1% each year. The report says that the demand for water is projected to rise faster in developing countries, and it also highlights that more than 5 billion people, they could be facing water shortages by 2050. It says that about 80% of the industrial and municipal wastewater is discharged without treatment. So a huge quantum of waste from the industries and households, it is being disposed into different river bodies without any treatment, which is very crucial, which is something we should work upon. Drought is arguably the greatest single threat from climate change. So these are the key highlights of this particular report, and we must be aware about these particular highlights. So now we can easily answer this question that according to the UN World Water Development Report, the global demand for water is increasing at the rate of about 1% per year over the past decades. So answer to this one is going to be option number B, 1%. So guys, this is all about our discussion on some of the very important MCQs based on the reports which were published recently and which were very important for our examination. Thank you guys. If you found this video useful, please like the same and share it with your friends. And for more similar videos, please subscribe to our channel on YouTube. Thank you.